الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفوته من خلقه وحبيبه، قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في سبيل دينه حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم اجزه عنا وعن والدينا وعن الإسلام والمسلمين خير ما جازيت به نبيًا عن قومه ورسولًا عن أمته. اللهم أحينا على سنته وأمتنا على ملته، واحشرنا تحت لوائه وأوردنا حوضه، واسقنا من يده الشريفة شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. أما بعد، الله سبحانه وتعالى tells us in the Quran فاتبعوا ملة إبراهيم حنيفة. Follow the faith, the religion, the way of life of Ibrahim the upright, the one that who tilts nowhere but where the guidance of Allah is. Prophet Ibrahim himself, so that we know what is Millata Ibrahim, what Ibrahim was asking Allah and what Allah made him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that as Ibrahim and Ismail were building the Kaaba, they were making a prayer. Among this prayer, it's a long prayer, they say, رَبَّنَا وَجَعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَيْنِ لَكَ. His grandchildren, when their father asked them, whom are you going to worship after me? مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِي؟ قَالُوا نَعْبُدُ إِلَهَكَ وَإِلَهَ آبَائِكَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ إِلَهًا وَاحِدًا وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ. So Ibrahim didn't ask to be Abraham or to have a religion named after him. He himself wanted to be a Muslim, and Allah told him, قال أأسلمت؟ قال أسلمت لله رب العالمين. He said, yes. Have you submitted yet, Ibrahim? He said, yes, I have submitted to Allah, the Lord of the worlds. After the Crusaders had failed to change the history of where Islam is heading, and after colonial power failed to persuade or pressure Muslims to change their faith, and after what is called the campaigns of conversion conducted by colonial and post-colonial powers to convince Muslims to leave their faith and follow whatever they want, they came now with the idea of melting Muslims in the pot of Abrahamic religion. As if we don't know Ibrahim. It reminds me of the executive director of the Southern Baptist Church, with whom I had an interview on CNN on the advent of the invasion of Iraq. And many evangelical Christians went there with their Bibles with them and water and other stuff, under the cover of and the protection of the American army and the auspices of some forces, local forces, to invade Iraq and to invite Muslims to introduce Christ to Muslims. And in this interview, the host of CNN asked him, why are you going there? He said, we're going to inform Muslims about Jesus, to give them the blessing, but primarily to give them clean water because there's no clean water, to give them food because they are in camps. And then the host asked me, what do you think of this? I said, I don't have a good word to say, but the word I would say is, I want your guest to know that, his name is Dr. Kelly, you can look after her. Anyway, I told him that Muslims in Iraq, which I visited twice before the war, in 2000 and 10 days before the war, I was in Iraq with a religious delegation to try to avert the war. We were not successful, but I visited there and I attended a service in a church invited by the leadership of the church. And I told them, listen, Christians in the Muslim world are living neighbors and friends, and some of them are wives with the Muslims, business partners, before America was discovered. So they know Jesus very well. They know Jesus as we are told about him in Islam, and they know him as the Christian that, or the Muslim that people claim he is a Christ, he is Christian, he is this, and they are following him. They are following him in a way that is different from what we do. We believe he's a prophet and he's a great person in history, and he is as much a prophet as our prophet, but we do not worship him. So what your guest is trying to do is to get Muslims to worship Christ. And I'm going to tell him from now, that's not going to happen. First of all, we know Jesus very well. We are not waiting for America to be discovered and for Dr. Kelly to hit the Southern Baptist Church to come and go with the tanks to invite Muslims to Christianity. Thank you for your water. So now, with all of those efforts failing, pressure, wars, killing, all of this, Muslims are still living with Christians, and Christians are still living with Muslims in the Middle East. We're not fighting. Muslims are fighting against each other over a piece of here and a piece of land there. But we're not fighting Christians. We're not killing Christians, as they claim we are. And we are not enemies of Jesus. But the last plan that came to them is the plan of making Abrahamic faith and building three buildings for Christian, Jews, and Muslims in the land of Abu Dhabi, and to invite them to become brothers. We know that we are brothers with everybody, Christians, Jews, Buddhists. We are, as humans, we are one family. We all came from Adam. We're going to continue to be his children. And as Islam tells us, we must treat each other fairly, justly, and peacefully. So I wanted to share this with you, because the media is pushing that, and there is a lot of writing and research done on this subject to make us feel if you don't join. So they were able to even recruit Muslim sheikhs, so to speak, to come and say, yes, we are all Abrahamic, we all belong to Ibrahim, we belong to Allah the Creator, and we are created from dust, and we are created from Adam, and we're going to continue to believe in Jesus only as a prophet. We're going to continue to believe that Muhammad is the last prophet that Allah had sent, and that every human being should study Islam and decide for himself whether or not he wants to follow Islam. We are not converting anybody. We are not in that process, and we are not pressuring anybody, and definitely we are not raising a sword in anybody's face. This is Islam, and Islam is a religion that is accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Religion that is recognized by Allah is nothing but submission, full submission. No hesitation, no reluctance. This is what Muslims are about, and this is what we believe the Quran sent to all humans to study and decide. We're not telling you accept it. It's a matter of your choice. But don't try to convert us. Thank you. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأصلي وأسلم على خير خلقه وخاتم رسله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحابته ومن اتبع سنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Brothers and sisters, we need to educate our community, especially our children who have not had the chance that you have to read the Quran, to read the Quran in Arabic, to understand the Quran, to know what Islam requires of you. Our children are vulnerable for such malicious invitations. So please, invite them to Islam. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت، وعافنا فيمن عافيت، وتولنا فيمن توليت، وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك، ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك، ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا، واجعله الوارث منا، واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا، ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا، ولا إلى النار مصيرنا. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم، فستذكرون ما أقول لكم، وأفوض أمري إلى الله، إن الله بصير بالعباد. وأقم الصلاة.